One of the key challenges in the modern space industry is trying to get your satellites into orbit. It can take sometimes decades. We need to find ways of accessing space more cheaply and more quickly. When I was looking at opportunities after graduating, I saw that there was an emerging trend called CubeSats. It's a very small satellite, and a team of perhaps 3 to 4 people can build and get it into orbit within a year, 2 years. This is incredibly empowering for many, many people who have different ideas about what they want to do in space. Back in the UK, no one was building or launching these satellites. Then I was fortunate enough to meet my current boss, the founder of Clyde Space, and we worked on the first satellite, UCube-1. We were very fortunate that through our industrial links, we were able to approach the UK Space Agency. What they said to us was, if you can build it, we'll launch it. That's where it began. It was both a surprise and terrifying. We had about a week to hastily put together the initial model of the satellite that was made out of gloss photographs of solar panels, a bit of plasterboard, and lots of late nights. Within 6 weeks, we had 22 different proposals of missions that people wanted to perform in space. Anything from an imager to take pictures for observing the Earth, a scientific payload, which is performing a measurement of space plasma, to a telecoms payload for commercial activity, or it can be educational. The satellite was launched on the 8th of July, 2014. First we heard about the launch was a tweet. We worked out where the satellite would be passing overhead and waited to hear it. The first thing that we heard was a small Morse code beacon, shout out to my daughter. UCube-1 calling Midori. There was a few tears shed when we heard it for the first time. It was a fantastic feeling, but then there was the next challenge, and that was how to operate a satellite when you can't just go up there and press a reset button. You have maybe 20 minutes a day where you can actually talk to this satellite. It's kind of a pioneer spirit that engineers have to push the boundaries of what is possible. You have to just focus on something that you believe in passionately and go for it.